certainly born free at Surrey Hills. I reckon this lad takes a 34 uplift. Get those crazy antics. What a cast! You could say the cats at Surrey Hills are born free too, you know. There's poor old Tiddles and Mickey. And there's a young brood from next door but one. I think that one's Tiger Little. Yes, I wonder what there is beyond. Anyway, it's a gay life, isn't it? Now for some fun. Have you ever tried to put a tent up for the first time? We're going to see a bit of action now. You watch the speed this tent goes up at. Oh well, go going in now. I'm sure this tent should be higher than this, though. Ah, yes, there it goes. Ursula waits impatiently. She says she's hungry. How about that then? It's almost up. We're almost in residence too. In fact, we're stuffing grub down us already. And that only took us 2 hours. Well, with food and drink inside us, how about a terrifying walk along the cliffs? From Durgledore to Lulworth Cove. Passing on our way, the Man of War Rocks. Ursula's walking the other side of the fence in case the cliffs give way. Sit here for a while and take in the lovely view of Lulworth Cove, and perhaps absorb a little sunshine too. That was a quick move, wasn't it? From Lulworth Cove to Cork Castle. We're obviously on our way home again, via the New Forest, I shouldn't wonder. Cadman, and eventually Newlands Corner on our way home. You'll notice on this film we get around rather rapidly. Thank you. That's what they wore in 1962, is it? Dig that crazy gear coming towards you now. I told you we got around a bit on this film. I don't know what I filmed this bit for, I suppose it helps to prolong the agony. Well, how about that for an eye blinder? Actually, joking aside, this is an interesting little ferry trip. There you can see the masts of the Victory and the Admiralty Building. In 1962, it only cost threepence, that's old pence of course, there's a clearer view of the Admiralty Building. Picture behind. And a quick return trip back to